Your TI calculator can manipulate fractions pretty easily. Okay? Your fraction key is located right here. Okay? That A represents the whole number part, the B represents the numerator part, and the C represents your denominator part. This fraction key separates every component of your fraction. So, for example, you want to enter the fraction 3/4. Okay. You'll press the 3 key, then you'll press the fraction key, and then you'll press the 4 button. This is how it looks when you enter. All that backward mark means is that you've separated the components of your fraction. When you press the enter button, this is how the fraction will look on your screen. Okay. Now, what happens if you want to enter in a mixed numeral, 3.5? Well, you do the same thing. Okay. Only you'll just have an extra 2 buttons to push. Here's your 3, your fraction key, your 1, your fraction key, and then your 2, fraction key. Now notice those separation marks are the same. It really doesn't matter. All your calculator knows is that this is your whole number, this is your numerator, and this is your denominator. Press enter, and that is how your fraction looks as a mixed number. 3, that stands for units. Notice how it's shaped like a little U. 3 units and 1/2 of your next number. Now sometimes a mixed number isn't the correct method for an answer. Okay? Sometimes you need to convert your number into an improper fraction. Your calculator can do that also. Notice that you've got this fraction key, but right above it, you have this ABC with these two arrows right there and a DE. Your calculator converts. Now, because this is up here, we need our second button before we can access the conversion. So we'll press the second key and our fraction key. Now notice what's on the screen. What your calculator is prompting you to do is take your answer and please convert the way it looks. To let the calculator know, yes, I'd like you to do this, please, I press the enter key. So 3.5 is the same thing as 7/2. That's pretty spiffy. It does the same thing in reverse, by the way. 3.5. Okay. Now, that's not all your calculator does. Your calculator also reduces. How cool is this? Let's say you've got an answer of 75/135. I don't know about you, but those numbers look kind of big. Wouldn't it be great if your calculator could reduce this automatically? It does. 75, press my fraction button, 135, and now I press enter. The reduced form of this fraction is 5/9. Rockin' awesome! Your calculator adds, subtracts, multiplies, and divides fractions also. So let's take 7/10 and add it to 11/15. Okay. 7/10 plus 11/15, and that equals 1 13/30. Pretty spiffy. Another great thing that your calculator can do is convert to decimals. That is so awesome. Okay. This is your mixed number. To convert this to a decimal equivalent, we can hit this F to D command. That stands for fraction to decimal. Now, because we have these two arrows, it can go either way, fraction to decimal, decimal to fraction. And again, that command is sitting above a button, so we must hit the second key first. Now it's asking me, would you like me to change your format? Yes, please. So the equivalent decimal to 1 and 13 thirtieths is 1.43. That is a brief introduction to how your calculator can use fractions and even convert from fractions to decimals.